Hey, this is Frank. You are looking at a Toyota engine. It's a 3.5 liter V6, the 2GR-FE. In a previous video, I've talked about the importance of this VVTI variable valve timing oil line that goes from the back of the engine up to the valve cover. And I've talked about the importance of checking this line and replacing it if necessary so it does not rupture and cause an engine failure. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how you replace this line. I've done a video previously showing the process with the engine in the car. Of course, there's only about this much space, less than an inch, between the side of the engine and the fender, so you can not really see anything. But with the engine out of the car, you should be able to see very clearly the steps involved in checking and replacing this variable valve timing hydraulic oil line. So the first step is to remove this plastic cover. It has two M6 bolts with a 10 millimeter head. Okay, so the cover is off, and you can see the entire VVTI oil line. Okay, comes down. This is the rubber elbow that can leak or break, and the line comes down over here. It has a banjo bolt at either end with a 17 millimeter head, and it has one fastening bolt right here. It's another M6 with a 10 millimeter head. So we get this off. And now there is nothing impeding the removal of this line. So we're going to take a socket wrench with a 17 millimeter socket. Let's start with the back. Okay, this one is already loose. Normally it might take a little bit more effort to remove this banjo bolt. Now note that on cars with electric power steering, you can have direct access to this banjo bolt right here. But with cars that have hydraulic power steering, the power steering pump sits right here in front of the banjo bolt, and you have to get the power steering pump out of the way slightly so you can turn this bolt and remove it. And on some cars, moving this power steering pump that sits right here, like on a Camry ES350 Avalon, it can sort of be stubborn. So just be aware of that and be prepared to deal with it if necessary. So this banjo bolt comes right out, and be prepared to catch some oil when this happens, because there's this entire hydraulic pipe and the passage that is bolted to are filled with oil. So I have a catch can at the ready so you can catch any oil that drips out. So now we have one of the banjo bolts is out, and let's look at the top banjo bolt right here. So the top banjo bolt also breaks loose and comes right off. And here is our VVTI oil line. We've taken it off. Banjo bolts always have O-rings on either side. Okay, so you have an O-ring that goes on one side of the banjo fitting, and the other O-ring is on the banjo bolt on the inside. Okay, now this banjo bolt also has a filter. This is a an oil filter to catch debris. And when you're doing this job, take it out and clean it with brake cleaner. Get it nice and clean. Unclog the screen so it'll function more efficiently. Okay? So that's how you remove the oil line. And again, the reason we're removing it is because of this rubber elbow that can leak and fail. And we're going to replace it with an all metal line. So this is one style of metal line that can be used for this replacement. This metal line is actually designed for the 2GR-FE that have the TRD supercharger, or for the Lotus Evora 2GR-FE. And it has this special shape that avoids the supercharger assembly, both up here and down here, okay? Because you have pulleys for the supercharger belt. And so in the description, I'm including the part numbers for the stock Toyota metal line. And I just don't have one on hand, so that's why I'm demonstrating using this TRD or Lotus line. Okay, now when you replace this line, you have the special paired banjo bolts. Okay, and these fit right on the banjo fitting. These fit right on the banjo fitting, then the banjo bolt goes through, and then it can be threaded in to the engine. Now, the cardinal rule when you do this is be extremely careful and avoid cross-threading anything. Like, make sure that you can rotate several turns by hand without any effort, and this ensures that you do not cross thread. And then do the same thing on the top side. We would have both banjo bolts, and just thread the banjo bolt in by hand. Okay, and you need both copper gaskets on both sides. And then, when you have these snug, you can tighten them down. And the correct torque for these bolts, I'm going to include also in the description. So that's it for how to replace the line. Of course, you would have the option to put the plastic cover back on or leave it off. Thank you for watching, and hope you've enjoyed this video.